Antone J. Baroni, a.k.a. Dad, Uncle Tony, Coach, and Grandpa Dude, was born September 11th, 1917, in Castellammare di Golfo, Sicily. His humble beginnings began in this city, on the west side of the island between Trapani and Palermo. His story, and the story of the Baroni family, goes something like this. This is Rosa and Antonio Baroni. They're the parents of this man, Angelo Baroni. There's another side. Leonarda and Giuseppe Chiratolo, they're the parents of this woman, Maria Chiratolo. Angelo and Maria met, were married, and started a family. Trying to find a better existence for his family, Angelo traveled solo aboard the steamship Madonna to the United States. 15 months later, Angelo Baroni sent for his family. This is the Argentina, the steamship they traveled on. The following documents reveal this. Maria brought over the children they had at that time. There was Rosa, Antone, and Giuseppe. Frank and Peter were born a few years later in the United States. Arriving on Ellis Island in 1921, the family lived in Endicott, New York. This did not last long. Like many of the immigrants of that time, the Baronis left the East Coast and relocated to the North Beach section of San Francisco, California. The city by the bay had yet to rise from the ashes of the 1906 earthquake, and the Depression was about to serve our country's economy a black eye. These were not easy times for the Baroni family, but it didn't matter. La familia era insieme. The family was together. That's all that mattered. Growing up in San Francisco in the 1930s for Tony wasn't easy. He never finished high school and hustled on the streets. He ran with gangs as a means for survival. He was always looking to strike a deal or hit a lick. You see, in those days, you had to be tough and have street smarts in order to survive. As tough as he was, there was one person who managed to put him in his place. Frances. She was the love of his life and the rock of our family. Just before heading to serve in World War II, she accepted his hand in marriage in November of 1941. Their marriage lasted 61 and a half years until her passing in 2003. Frances bore him four beautiful daughters. Marianne, or how Grandpa would say it, my financial person. The twins, Rosie and Connie, fondly referred to as Wosie and Conchette. And the baby of the bunch, Nina, a.k.a. Little Baby. During the 1950s, Tony started to work as a poultry clerk as a means to provide for his family. He was magnificent with cuts of meat.
Baby, you go this way, see? One. Turn around. Come on, get into the hole. You get right in the joint, you see? One. Two. Let it go. Quick, go. And then you do like this. You wash your hands, you dry, then you blow your nose. Then you get your knife, you go like this. You cut that way. You cut it this way, see?
Tony was always trying to feed people and give them food. The basement in the house on Mariposa smelt like a deli. He grew his own vegetables and cured his own olives. Once he broke his arm picking olives at a rest stop off I-5. That's how serious he was. And oh yeah, he was always good for telling a joke or two.
What's this here remind you of?
Shiggle, shiggle.
Huh?
What is it?
Tooth.
What is it? Look at it. What does he remind you of?
Tooth.
The keel of a boat. That's it.
Yeah.
Okay. This is it. The bosom.
He knew everything there was to know about being a butcher. You think you knew more than him? Try telling him what to do.
Yeah, you don't hold your hands on the ear bunnies.
Don't worry about my hands, buddy. I'll take care of it. Okay, okay. That's now wash it. Wash everything. We cook everything here. Hey, come back here.
Don't lose any down there.
No, no, no.
That's important.
I'll take my hands in
here. The family lived in San Francisco until 1959, then they moved to Daly City. Tony continued to be a poultry clerk until he retired in the late 1970s. He stayed in Daly City with Grandma Frances until 1999. They moved to Redding.
One child grows up to be somebody that just loves to learn, and another child grows up to be somebody you just love to burn. Mom loves the both of them, you see it's in the blood. Both kids are good and mom. Thicker than the mud, it's a family affair.
Tony was into a lot of things. He loved cooking, he liked watching wrestling, he especially loved to follow the Giants. But most of all, Tony loved spending time with his family.
Great grandpa.
That's the great grandpa. Grandpa Dude.
Grandpa Dude.
I did get a chance to go to a Giants game.
Grandpa Dude. Hey. Give me a hand. Give me a hand.
Hey, give me five.
Really good.
Okay.
This you don't want to do it. He hit his cousin. Hey. Wait, watch your dog hit his head on this one. See your cousin now. Wait till you get over, you want to punch him in the nose.
That grandpa
sucks. I got him. Take it easy, buddy.
You have a squealy hog. Squealy pig.
I need them all, man. Save me a couple of these.
Oh, nice play.
Beautiful. You put your pasta the next time you come in, I'll fill this up pasta for you, okay?
Yeah, thank you.
Let's put my four daughters.
That's your bill. I'll be sitting in the You know what? I'm personally coming over and throwing the other ones
watching
away.
Why?
Because that's the reason we got those. And I watch the frying pans are so horrible. You need new ones. That's why I bought new ones. I'm sitting on the little tiny dinky thing. There's three of them here. Watching the tide. All right, let Mama open hers now.
You just come to do some video productions. Sitting
on the dock of the bay. Sean, hold them up. No, closer together.
Oh, yeah.
I left my home in Georgia, headed for the Frisco Bay. Cause I've had nothing to live for, and look like nothing's gonna come my way. So I'm just gonna sit on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on a dock of a bay, wasting time. Look like nothing's gonna change. Everything still remains the same. I can't do what 10 people tell me to do, so I guess I'll remain the same. Listen. sitting here resting my bones, and this loneliness won't leave me alone. This 2,000 miles I roam just to make this dock my home. Now I'm just gonna sit at the dock of a bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on a dock of a bay, wasting time.
Through his loins have come 4 children, 7 grandchildren, 13 plus great-grandchildren, a great-grandchild, with more to come. Although Tony is no longer with us, let us be thankful for the times we shared with him. The man, the husband, the father, the icon, the legend. We love you, Grandpa. You will be missed.